Views and opinions expressed on Marty's Corner do not reflect those of this cable station, any city cable board, its management or staff. In fact, they do not reflect my opinion or the opinion of anyone I know. They do not reflect the opinion of the People's Republic of China or the people in the land down under we call Australia. Some of the views and opinions don't even reflect the opinion of Marty. They're just abstract little things that he says to fill time without really thinking about it. The only person with sole responsibility for content on this program is the producer, who, if anything should go wrong or be deemed generally offensive or out of line, will be made to pay dearly. And now sit back and enjoy Marty's Corner.
It's Marty's Corner! Starring Marty Shields! With special guest DJ Kennedy. I'm your announcer, Tony Ridley. On tonight's show, star of the John Kerwin Show, John Kerwin. Medium, Mark Nelson. Comedian, Georgi. And reggae, ska band, Dub 8. And now, those aren't eggs in his basket. Here's Marty Shields! Here's Marty Shields! Here's Marty Shields! Marty, has anybody seen Marty?
Hey, Tony, I think I saw a bum outside.
Not again! Ah!
God, every week.
Hey! Hey, not you again!
Come on, get loud, let's go. Again, welcome to Marty's Corner, and again, we want to thank all of you for joining us on Easter Eve here on Marty's Corner. And we want to go ahead and let people in the audience know, and of course people at home also to be aware of the fact that someone's in the audience, or rather in the studio, that's been with us before. He's actually an off-duty officer, and he comes in. He's our security normally on the show. And his job is to kind of make sure everything goes okay here in the studio. And of course, one of the jobs he also has, he's also in charge of making sure people laugh very loud and have a good time. And if you do not laugh or clap loud enough for Officer Dave, he will escort you from the studio. So it does behoove you to go ahead and be very loud. Now you might be wondering why Officer Dave is dressed the way he is tonight. Of course, one of our interns was supposed to wear the bunny outfit, and of course he came up sick. So how's that working for you, Dave? No? Okay. So, and that's Officer Dave here. So again, just be aware of the fact that, again, we want you to clap and get loud real quick. Yeah. He's watching you. We have a good show, of course. In the news, I've gained a little weight. As I can tell on the monitor, I've gained a little weight lately. Just a little bit here, just a little bit. Now, I'm not eating too much. It's all the collagen, the butt implants, and of course the boob job. Yeah. And I'm glad to say now I'm a solid C cup. That's right here. Just in time for summer. A new iPod is coming out this summer for 3 year olds. Have you heard about this? For 3 year olds, it's called the iPoddy. True. Yeah. It's made of rubber, and it only has two buttons, number one and number two. We've been getting a lot of emails here to the show, and some of the viewers have been asking if one of the people on our show, Tony, is single. That's right. They've been asking if Tony is single, and some of them are actually coming from women. So. Right, Tony. Actress Gwyneth Paltrow is in the news. She just gave birth to a new baby. She named the baby Moses. Yeah. Now, I think she's taking it a little bit too far. The baby's announcements were done on stone tablets. So, speaking of the Ten Commandments, she obviously did not read the one commandment that says, "Thou shalt not name a baby Moses." No. Not a baby Moses. Right there. Officer Dave. In a recent survey showed men use profanity 60% of the time during conversation. Women, on the other hand, use profanity in conversations about 39%. Now, that's if they're not talking about their exes, then it jumps to 100%. So, That's true. Vice President Cheney is in the news. Apparently, he threw out the ceremonial first pitch at the Washington Nationals home opener last week. Now, he hit the mascot right in the face. Yeah. And the bad thing was he wouldn't allow the mascot to get any kind of medical attention until the next day. Wow. We have a good show for you here on Marty's Corner, our 106th show live from Mike and I. Real quick, the show lineup tonight, of course, we have a gentleman who does a TV show over in Santa Monica. He's also a talk show host, and he'll be on in just a little bit to talk about that show. John Kerwin is here tonight. John Kerwin. Nice. We also have a gentleman on the show who's a medium. He actually talks to the spirits. And he'll be on tonight. He'll be showing us a little bit what he does in his off hours. And, of course, he has a website and all those kind of things. And he'll be on to do some of the things that he does best. Mark Nelson is here. Mark Nelson is here. Live. A comedian joins us. So this nice lady has been nice enough to come down on Saturday night. She's very funny. She plays all over Los Angeles, Orange County. And she'll be making her first appearance here in Marty's Corner. Georgi is here tonight. Georgi is here live. And last but not least, a group of musicians join us. These gentlemen, again, were great in sound check. We're looking forward to them performing tonight. Dub 8 is here tonight. Dub 8! Yep. Wow. They've seated the crowd. Obviously, they've seated the crowd. And, of course, to my left, as always, some great music coming out of this gym. He's going to play a little music for you right now. Can you please say hello to our good friend, Kennedy? Kennedy! Something different here on the show. What we did before the show started, we actually handed out 3x5 cards to our audience members, and we told them to go ahead and ask some questions to me. So if this bit doesn't go well, you're partially responsible. So, which I like. So we're just going to go and read off these questions here and the answers, and see what we have here. Mayonnaise and squirrels. About 9.5 inches. 9.5 inches, I guess, is about right.
Marty?
Yeah.
I think the bit works better if you read the questions. So maybe if you go back and read the questions.
That's our director, John, talking. Read the questions. Oh, and then the answers also.
Whatever.
That could actually work, huh? They were just addressed to me. Why do I have to? Okay. The first question, I'll read the first question. The first question was, name your favorite salad dressing and a vermin. And the other one was, what's the difference between, the height difference between you and your regular DJ Leo? But what I'll do, John, I'll just read the questions and the answers.
Yeah, maybe it wasn't a good idea.
Maybe it wasn't a good idea.
Yeah.
Here's one. It says, Marty, what's your favorite lunch meat? Peanut butter. Is this one's to Marty. What would you do if you found out you had one day to live? Kill myself. Question, is that a fake goatee? No, just the one on my face is. Everything else is real. Did you ever work at Robinson's May? Well, people actually work with me know I didn't, so that's a kind of question. When are you going to pay me? Who wrote this? Well, your services weren't that good, so I didn't want to pay you. Marty, who dresses you? Love your snappy wares. Stevie Wonder. Marty, who is your favorite comedian, or to be politically correct, or comedian? Alf. Alf is my favorite one. I'm not going to read that one. Are those size 12? Are they showing? Sorry. What is this one? Which show is your favorite, and which one do you wish you can do over? This one, obviously, because it's not going anywhere. Okay. Is your chair on the show comfortable? Yes, but my butt isn't, which is kind of an... And the last one here, do you prefer paper or plastic? Actually, my underwear is mesh. So thank you for writing those questions for us here on Marty's World. Our first guest is a gentleman who actually does a lot like what I do. He actually hosts a very cool and hip TV show over in Santa Monica. And before we bring him out, we want to go ahead and show you a little bit about what he does. So if you could just watch the monitor here in the studio, and of course, all you people at home, watch your TV and take it away anytime you guys are ready in the control room.
I thought since we have sort of like a connection here to end the interview, it might be kind of fun if I kissed you.
It would?
Would that be okay with you?
I'm sure that's fine.
Wow, this is going to be really, really exciting. For me, at least. Are you sure you're okay with it? Are you ready?
What is this, Madonna and Britney or something?
Okay, well, here we go. Come here.
Oh! To the go girl, right? See? They love you. They love you, John. They love you. They love you. Have a seat right here, Mr. Kerwin. Stand up again. They love you.
They're on something, aren't they?
Well, we do hand out things before the show, just to kind of loosen them up a little bit.
It's so good to be here. We're all dressed up. Look at us.
We're all dressed up. You got the memo. You look nice.
Well, look at these sleeves, though. Aren't they a little bit long?
I think the jacket's too short, man.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I'm a little bit self-conscious. I don't know anybody else has this thing, but I have thin wrists. So I had them make really long sleeves, but it looks really dopey. I think it's genetic, because my dad, although a very tough guy, has wrists like Dakota Fanning. They're just tiny. It's a genetic
like,
thing.
Like that. Wafer thin.
Yes, like wafer thin.
Wow.
You just recoil like I was going to try and kiss you as well.
I was afraid. I was watching the thing.
That would be a different kind of show.
Yeah.
You
might do that down in Santa Monica, but here in Hacienda Heights, we don't do that kind of stuff here. Beautiful Santa Monica. Tell us about your show. How long have you been doing the show? What's it all about?
Well, I've been doing the show. It's a comedy talk show for about 5 years, and we've had some terrific guests like Donnie Most, we just had, who is on Happy Days. Remember
Ralph
him?
Mouth, sure.
Ralph Mouth. We had on, Dick Van Patten. Remember him from Eight Is Enough?
Sure.
And Larry Hagman from Dallas. All the new kids in the business.
We've up and comers.
We have a rule. You have to be 65 or older to be
right?
on our show.
Hello, geriatrics on your show. Is that
some,
what it is?
Some. But we have some newer people as well. Nicole Richie is going to be on our show. So that should be exciting. And Michael Madsen. So we have kind of a mixture of the older Hollywood and the newer Hollywood. So It's very exciting. I actually started out. I was asking you backstage how you get the money to do this.
Right.
I actually got the money. I funded my show by being a champion on the Hollywood Squares.
Amazing.
And that's absolutely true. Do you guys want to know the question that won me $10,000?
Yeah.
All right. I'll ask you.
All right.
What actress has an Oscar-winning mother? Is it Gwyneth Paltrow, Melanie Griffith, or Kate Hudson? Does anybody know that answer?
I do know
what
that.
What do you say? Gwyneth Paltrow? Okay. What do you think?
I think it's Kate Hudson.
It is Kate Hudson. Goldie Hawn won for a movie called Cactus Flower. How about that for Marty?
Huh? Wow.
You started out
as a comedian back east. I know you've done writing, improv.
Yeah, I worked out actually at the Improv on Melrose in Hollywood, and I would introduce people like Jerry Seinfeld and Jay Leno, which is great training for a talk show host. And there were some great moments that I had there. There was one comedian that hated me, and were you laughing at him? It's hard to believe that this gentleman is standing there
right now. Dave?
It's like a drunk Limp Bizkit trying to get into the Playboy Mansion, you know? Please, I did Britney, let me in, Hef!
He's got a firearm, you need to watch out there, because this guy's ready to go. Look at
him. I'm sure that badge is really authentic.
Wow! He's see, he's staring like, you down.
I'm telling you, it was like Hang 'em High in Clint Eastwood.
And you were saying?
So I worked there. The one comedian that was really tough was a Rodney Dangerfield, who I was such a fan of.
Yeah.
But it was weird because like he had this odd little kind of phony thing that he would do when you would introduce him. And he'd have to be in the audience, and you'd kind of say, oh, we have a celebrity in the audience. And everybody would like look around, and he would be there and say, oh, Rodney Dangerfield. And he'd want everyone to applaud and everything.
Sure.
Maybe we can coax him onto the stage, you know? And then he would then decide whether or not he wanted to come on stage or not.
It wasn't a given.
And what I do is I introduce him, and I didn't get the crowd happy enough for him, and I said, Rodney Dangerfield, and he just stood there and went like that to me.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You should have had Officer Dave there, because he would have got the crowd going.
See, he would have gotten them rolling, yeah.
Fear is always good to have in an audience. So you said you start, wow, what's he doing? The show started, how long have you been on the air now? A couple, 4 or 5 years?
Yeah, 4 or 5 years, and my favorite show was when I had Dick Cavett on, along with Kathy Griffin and Charo. That was really
a fun show. I'm a big fan of Dick Cavett.
Yeah, Dick Cavett, one of the great talk show hosts, and is actually doing a new talk show host now on a talk show on Turner Classic Movies, which is going to be starting up now.
Is that right?
And they're going to have some of the clips from his old show, along with like kind of a 70s set like he had, and he's going to be doing new interviews.
I didn't know that.
He was a great interview. Very, very
I'm into Dick Cavett. I've got all the new DVDs that came out during Christmas, and I've been watching the heck out of it.
Oh, the Groucho Marx is really good.
Yes.
And also, it's particularly the Jack Benny and the Bill Cosby episode.
Right,
it's one of the best I've ever seen.
I watched that last night. It's funny you should say that. I watched that last night.
That's
any people that don't know Dick Cavett.
Means nothing to anyone in the audience
Dick
here.
Dick Cavett was great. He was like in the early 70s, and some people actually know who he was. And he was great. He only lasted about 4 or 5 years before they kicked him off the air.
But how about that Avril Lavigne?
She's
see, you gotta kind of.
Is that what it is?
You know, she's hot.
You gotta
right?
bring it down to there.
No.
Can you stay around a little bit here?
Absolutely.
Because we need to go for a commercial break, and we'll be right back with John Kerwin. We'll be right back. Don't go away, ladies and gentlemen. Good song. We're here talking with John Kerwin from The John Kerwin Show.
You guys have a band here. Is that
we
right?
have a real band here.
We don't.
I've seen your show. I finally saw your show, and you don't have a band.
Our studio is so small.
How small is it?
It sounds like a joke.
Yeah.
But what we do is we actually have a band called The Non-Existence.
Right, I've seen that.
And it's just instruments in the corner.
It's like a guitar and a chair or
because
something.
Because we can't afford it. We don't have the space. We can't afford any of the space.
I thought Santa Monica, you guys had all kinds of money down there in Santa Monica.
There's money in Santa Monica, but not at the studio.
It's not going your way?
No, not at all.
You're on channel 77, right?
Yes, all the way up there, 77, right.
And you're showing what days of the week or?
We're at 8 o'clock on Saturdays, right after Fly Fishing with Gus. So if you guys ever want to watch
That's your lead-in or something?
That's our lead-in. That's my joke lead-in for that.
You know, the funny thing is, when I first talked to you, we mentioned again that you know, you're a very private person, and of course, you do the talk show thing. And we did some investigation on you. I know you didn't know about this, John.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, yeah. And we actually had Officer Dave go around. And what he did was he went and we actually went online and actually found some photos of you that people don't really know. And these are, I guess, what John does when he's not hosting the John Kerwin Show.
Oh, this is private stuff. You didn't clear this with me at
all. No, this wasn't cleared. And here's a picture of John here. This is one of the things he does for fun, of course. He holds the target there. A little scary, John. A little scary. You need to close your legs on that one, I think, maybe. What else here? Okay, and here's a picture of John in his earlier career. Of course, he was a wrestling midget. And there's a shot of John. Right there.
Notice the hefty bulge, though.
Right there, yeah.
There's something.
That's
there.
Impressive. That's impressive.
Thank you.
That's impressive. And of course, he also was a dancer. And here's a shot of him as a ballerina. Great legs. Great legs. And maybe next time you come on, you can maybe do a little bit kind of like dancing for us or something.
Yeah, you just want to see me in a tutu.
That's all I want. You know
that's
my audience would love that.
There's more?
We have more. Of course we have more. Oh, there's one more in here. I know there is.
Is this going to be the big embarrassing one?
I don't know. Hold on. I thought I had one more. I do have one more. It's hiding. Oh. And of course, and of course, here's John winning best of show. You got some odds out of that, though. You got some odds out of it.
They actually based the movie Best in Show on my career, my early career.
Is that what it was?
Saw that? Yes, absolutely.
And after you've been on this show, it's all downhill from that. You know that, don't you? can you stay around? Because we have a gentleman coming on right now. Again, I'm not sure if you're into this kind of stuff. This gentleman is a medium, and I guess he talks to spirits and those kind of things, and he's going to come on and talk a little bit about that. Can you hang around a little bit?
Absolutely.
Okay. Jamie, can you please welcome to our stage Mark Nelson. Mark, come on out, Mark! Come on over. Have a seat right here, Mark. Have a seat. They love you. They love you. They're eating you. Mark Nelson, you're a medium.
That's right.
We got a hold of you. I guess you have a MySpace account. What do you do exactly as a medium? How did you get involved in that?
Well, I started getting messages from, it sounds strange, it started out as what I thought was a dream. And it's almost but like more of a daydream. And it started out where I moved away from my family, who live out here, and then I moved back. But while I was away, I would start getting things like, Glenn, my brother Glenn, is surrounded by green ivy. It's like, what does that mean? What does that mean? And then I got messages about another brother who worked in a place where he'd have to walk through a certain kind of door. And so then I started calling my mom and said, Mom, does this mean anything to you? She says, yeah, it does. That does mean something. And it turns out that my brother worked just gotten a new job in a place called the Ivy, where it looked just like the logo. And I thought that was very interesting.
And these were dreams you had.
Well, no, they weren't dreams. It started out where I would start taking walks. And these thoughts would pop into my head. And it would coincide with me seeing my father. My dad passed away when I was very young. And I have another great dad who's here tonight. But when I walk, I would get these clips where I'm walking and I'm seeing my father. And he's telling me things about my brothers and sisters who were thousands of miles away. And I thought, this is really kind of weird, but I'm going to just go with it. And so it started to persist. So I started writing it down because I wanted to see, what does this mean? I mean, you know, just it's one thing to have just odd ideas pop into your head, but they kept coming through on a more regular basis. And then my grandmother passed away, and I started to get more messages. And this time it was like my grandfather showing up. And what I mean by that is, you know, it's like, I would take where we lived, I could go for a long walk, be out in the country, and I would see pictures of my dad, my grandfather. And he would tell me things to tell my mom that she's not alone, that there was a situation where he told me a phrase, tell your mom when she hears the phrase, well, white carnations do, it's going to mean something. All right, sure, I'll go with that.
Yeah.
And so I called mom and I said, write this down. You're going to hear when you're back for the funeral, well, white carnations do. Well, my grandmother passed near Valentine's Day. And so my mom was making funeral arrangements and she wanted a certain type of fall, an arrangement. And so she says, I'd like these to be white roses. And the guy says, no, we're out. Well, white carnations do.
Really?
And so that really stopped her. And so, but the message was supposed to be reassuring that it's like, you're not alone. Your dad is here.
So it's not he's a scary helping. Thing. It's not a scary thing.
No. It started out all for me for family members coming through trying to give reassuring messages, you know, that, you know, you don't have to deal with issues on your own. You don't have to go through difficult times on your own. And that they're aware of what's happening in your life. And so after figuring out that, well, it works for family, all right, let's see, maybe I should go out and see if it works for people I don't know.
Right.
And so I walked into a metaphysical bookstore and I said, you know, I think I'm psychic. Well, how do you know? I said, well, let's find out, you know. And so I did a reading for the lady of the store, and then she said, okay, read my boyfriend. And so her boyfriend came over, and I started to describe, like, says, you have one sister who has, like, blondish hair about this long, and she's showing me, in fact, you're one of four kids, and three of them are girls. I mean, you're the only guy, and you have three sisters. Yeah. He says, well, one of them is kind of about 5'4". I'm seeing, like light brown hair. And she, no, I don't. He's saying, that one isn't right. And I said, well, she's showing me a rusted-out Volkswagen Beetle. What does that mean? Oh, her. She's dead. Oh, okay. All right. So now we're getting somewhere. Okay, so this one, she's telling me that she died from... she's saying that there was an illegal aspect to what... There's something illegal about how she passed. And she said, oh, yeah, she died from a cocaine overdose. And then who's the last... Then they started to get interested. Who was the last person in the room? And I said, there's a guy named John. Who's John? John. And John was her brother-in-law, who was a policeman, who was trying to get this woman to stop using drugs. And so, okay. And so they put me on the schedule pretty quickly, and I was able to do some work for a while. And it's been very rewarding.
What we're going to have Mark do in a little bit here, we've actually collected some items from our cast and crew and some audience members. And we're going to go ahead and probably lay him on the table here and have Mark kind of look at him, see if he gets any kind of, I guess, vibes off him. Is that what it would be?
It's called psychometry.
Psychometry, okay.
When I do readings for clients, I'll just to see what I get, I'll pick up. I mean, I think there's energy attached to everything. Your studio would have just anything they would have. So I pick it up, and it's usually like a jump into what is going on in their life. It may be you just went through this, you're experiencing this, you're facing a big choice. And I try to be more specific, okay, you know, about what it means.
So what we're going to do is, Mark needs to go ahead and kind of, I guess, get in touch with, I guess, what do you do? Like, you kind of breathe, you...
Yeah, it's a little bit of meditation.
Okay.
I basically take a little time to myself, you know, when I've done parties where it's very loud and bright like this.
Yeah.
But I like to clear my head a little bit and try not to think about any... It's sort of like I need to get out of the way of spirit coming through for you, say, if I did a reading for you.
Right.
I want to not think about the fact that, okay, I can look and see certain things about you. Some people call that, some psychics, they'll do a cold read. I try to get out of the way so that I can just listen to what's coming through.
Yeah. So you're going to take off for about 5 minutes, and we're going to ask you back a little bit. Mark,
absolutely.
Will you take off a little bit?
All right, thank you very much.
We head off that way, Mark, and we'll take off.
Absolutely.
And Mark will be back in a little bit. Head on over to Mark. Go ahead and go on through. I know. But he has to kind of calm down before he can read, because there's just too much going on.
He has to get into a state of mind,
I guess,
where
so.
He can then see things.
Yeah. Normally, I drink a lot to do that. But it's just not the
maybe
same.
Maybe that's what he's doing. Maybe he's getting some tequila.
We
maybe Tila tequila, since he's on MySpace.
Oh, I saw that, in fact. She's hot.
You guys know Tila?
Yeah. She's on your... I saw that. That's pretty hot.
Maybe you can tell us if she's available.
Well, we can find out.
We
have a comedian right now who's going to join us. This nice lady, again, has come down tonight. Again, she plays all through L.A. County, Orange County, and she'll be making her first appearance on the show. Can you please give a warm welcome to Georgi? Georgi, come on out!
Thank you very much. Well, I'm no Alf. But I am 100% Greek. Basically, all that means is I live in constant fear of facial hair. And my mother, she's from the old country, and she loved to spew these hexes. This was her favorite. She'd go, Georgia, naekis helia senkesena. Loosely translated, Georgie, may you bear 1,000 children like you. I got to tell you, I ended up having six. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And let me tell you, they all turned out to be just like my parents. Yeah. Difficult to deal with and selfish. I mentioned once I wanted to be buried in my homeland of Greece. Should have seen how excited they were about the trip to Europe. And I got to tell you, they range in age from 30 to 8. Yeah. Yeah. And it looks damn certain the 8-year-old will be moving out before the 30-year-old. Mm-hmm. And they're really a cute little group, but even though they're no longer sucking the, you know, nursing, they do suck the life out of me, you know? It's another Greek thing. If I say something, I don't want to come true. Let me just show you. Oh my God, I wished I was dead. See? But then you go, oh my God, I wish my stepmother were dead. Let's see. What was I going to tell you about? Well, you know, our one daughter, she has dual personalities. Trouble is they're both bitches. Oh, I'm so serious. And she's dating. I don't know how that happened, but he's one of those guys that wear those big old baggy pants down to there. You know those pants? They make me so uncomfortable that when he leaves our house, I go see if my big screen TV is still there. And then I got to hear her go, God, I can't believe you and Daddy don't talk to him more. He's so smart. How intelligent do you got to be to buy the right size Levi's? Honest to God. You know, and our other daughter, we've been forced to nickname her Parsley. She looks good and does nothing. Unless, of course, you do count dating, in which case I've given birth to a blow-up doll. Oh, you know what? No. Stop. No, I'm serious. Every high school has the hoodlum, the bitch, and the slut. What they don't tell you is they can all come from one nice woman. Serious. And the principal, he has our number on a speed dial, which is irritating. You see, I pay my taxes. 8 to 3, his responsibility, right? At night during my shift, I have never, ever called him. Wimp. And I know, people always go, oh, Georgie, you shouldn't talk about your kids like that. Where would you be without them? Hawaii. Absolutely. And you know, I realize, you know, kids, you can't live without them or you end up in the newspapers. You gotta love them. Gotta love them. There is a silver lining, though. That would be my husband. He's a really nice guy. We actually got married through a miscommunication. You know, he came up to me and he said, hi, I'm Tim, I'm Irish. I heard, hi, I'm Tim, I'm rich. It's made him rude. He says things to me like, Georgie, how many dresses do you feel you need? How much sex do you feel you need? You know what I mean? Yeah. But we are so going to be married forever because he, like, really loves his house. But no, there's another reason, because he knows if he left, I would give him total and complete custody of those kids. Yes, I would. He would be lucky if I asked for drive-by visitation. Honest to God. 2 weeks. Hi, kids, it's Mom. Have them on the lawn. I'll be back 2 weeks. I'll take you to Disneyland. Yeah. By the way, Disneyland really would be the happiest place in the world if they didn't allow kids. Sorry. No. You know, when I found out I was pregnant with my last baby after a break of 16 years, yeah, I know. I called my sister for some support, self-righteous, opinionated spinster bitch that she is. She says to me, Georgie, what do you expect when you're having sex? Usually just a new dress. Yeah. And you know what, though? You know, when you're pregnant and you have the baby shower, they always give you these books, and you never really read them. But on your sixth pregnancy and having the kids I've had, you know? Because I got to tell you what I would have done for one nerd to be able to call my, honestly, to call my parents and say, Mom, Dad, yes, your grandson, 8:30 Jeopardy. Right? Wouldn't that be cool? Not me. I'm going, Mom, Dad, yeah, your grandson, yeah, yeah. 8:30 Superior Court. Oh, I can, please, let me tell you. But I did. I read these books. And you know what they say, the sickest thing? They say if you tell your child from the start the truth, it will be a well-adjusted adult. Okay, experts. You betcha we favor your sister. That is not a picture of Daddy. That is called scribbling. And I'm not going to buy a frame for it. You've already wasted the paper. Oh. You know what? Daddy drinks because you cry. And that is my time. I'm Georgie.
John.
Yeah,
I know. Georgie, have a seat right here, sweetheart. Wow. Have a seat. Man.
Hey, gotta be honest about
you. You don't hold nothing back, do you?
That's why the psychic had to leave.
I think so. He knew that was coming. You've been doing comedy for how long now?
About 8 years.
And you're Greek. You said how you had a bad day today, you were telling me, before you came in the studio.
Oh, I had such a bad day.
What constitutes a bad day for you?
Well,
maybe a lot.
Aside from the kids, yeah. You know, I have 4 of them at home and 2 are kind of on the revolving door plan. And I'm superstitious. I'm always wearing evil eyes or whatever. But today I have a certain routine I have when I'm going to perform. And it was quite simple. I don't do nothing. I do my thing. I rest. That's it.
Yeah.
My friend called. She had an emergency. And I went to, she needed to go to the train station to drop her son off. Well, she missed the first train, which, okay. And I kept trying to tell her she's ADD. She just doesn't believe me. Second time, we go back. I've sat in the parking lot. I visited. Now we got the second train. And I say, just run in and run out. I have got to go home. I am going to be with him tonight.
That's right.
That's right. Him? And lo and behold, 1 minute, Marty.
Okay.
1 minute, 2 minutes, you know, 20 minutes. She took the keys to the car. It's hot. I'm in Santa Ana. I'm not happy. I got the kids in the car. I'm really not happy. And all of a sudden she calls and she's crying and she's like, Georgie, they closed the train door and I'm on my way to Oceanside. Oceanside. They closed the train doors on her. And she was, and there I was.
And that was just today?
Just today. I got home at, we left at 9 o'clock. At 2:40 I was home. Upset. Pissed off.
Wow.
Upset. Yeah.
Well, we're so glad you came down and had a good time here on the show. You have any gigs coming up? Where are you performing lately?
Actually, I've been doing a lot of out-of-town work. I did New York on West 73rd, stand-up New York. And I just did a little club. I can't really recall the name, but I've been to the Improv, the Comedy Store, and up and around doing a lot of things. I do extra work. I keep busy.
If you have a phone and people want to get a hold of you, what's the best way to get a hold of you?
They can call me at 714-799-4891. Okay. That's the kids' line. That should fix it.
Yeah. Wow.
we're going to bring Mark back real quick because he's had time to kind of breathe and kind of chi or whatever he's doing back in the other room. So if we could go get... Yes? Yes?
He's back
there. Oh, thank you so much. Okay. Can we go ahead and bring Mark back in? Mark, will you come back in?
Well, you were very funny.
Mark, come on back in. Mark, yeah. George, you have a seat. I'm collecting all the items that were given to me, so we're going to go ahead and, again, I guess pretty much lay these on the table, and Mark's going to go ahead and see if he gets any readings off these. I think this is it. Let me look one more time. We don't want to lose any keys or walls. Okay. All right, Mark.
Okay. I'm just going to pick up an item. If someone recognizes that it is theirs, I'm going to see what vibes, what messages I get off of it. If someone, do you mind if they say yes or no?
No, that's fine.
Okay. Well, I'm going to pick up the dog because that's probably... Okay, the first thing that comes to mind when I pick this up, I'm hearing three kids. Does anybody own this? Whoever can validate that.
That would...
The dog?
It's John's.
It's John's.
Okay, okay.
Okay. To be honest, it feels like it's been in a drawer for a long time.
Okay. Is this right, John? Is our director John?
In the garage.
Okay, it's been out of circulation for a long time. It feels like everything else is long gone. All right. John, is there a baby? It feels like there's a baby energy. I don't know if you've recently had a child.
There's a baby.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, don't give this to the baby. He's going to choke on it. Okay, it's got sharp edges. Only bad things are going to come from that. Okay. Is it a boy?
Yes.
Okay. J name? Jay?
Yes.
Okay. John, that wasn't... All right, there you go. I want to say over 8 pounds at birth? 8 pounds?
Yes.
Okay. Like 11 ounces or something? Close?
Close.
Okay.
Well, you're no good.
Yeah.
You had 11
and
ounces.
I hope something ahead. Yeah. I see bad things coming yeah. this way. Yeah.
Oh, I know you're a fool.
All right. All right. I don't know what your plans are, but I think that there's another baby that will be following this one up. I know that's harder to validate. We'll have to come back, and I'll do one of your anniversary shows.
Right, to come back and make
okay.
sure.
But it feels like that there would be another girl around if there isn't one around. It feels like that there would be a girl to follow. Okay.
Actually, that makes sense.
Okay.
Wow.
All right. You're not from the Los Angeles area originally. That's something I'm picking. Is that correct?
Do you want me to tell you where I'm from?
All right. It feels like you were from farther east. I want to say, like, not East Coast, but maybe.
You know what? I'm not, but that may have come from the East Coast.
Oh, okay. All right.
Made in Pennsylvania. Says it right over there.
Oh, is that what that was? I think you're correct. Would you like to hold this? Well, let me see what I can... let me see.
Do you have time to do another one?
Absolutely.
Do you have time to do another one? Anything else there? Anything else can set your fancy?
Okay. I'm going to go for the wedding band. First thing I hear off of this, I don't know whose wedding band this is.
It's John's again.
Okay. I was going to say 3 years, married about 3 years.
Anybody?
All right. This hasn't been around on someone's ring that long. 3, maybe 4 years. All right. The first thing I want to say is that it feels like that the person who has this, their mother may have passed. I'm hearing mom says hello.
Anyone in the audience or a crew member?
Does anybody have this small wedding band?
Anybody?
It's a simple band.
Anyone? No.
Okay, I'm going to keep this, if that's okay. We have no
Is that
fibers.
How it works?
Yeah, it works out. It's kind of a profitable thing on the side. All right. Mom says hello. I'm hearing the word diabetes. I feel like the diabetes may have been an issue for the person the mom. I feel like it was a fairly recent passing. So, let me see if I can pick up something else. Maybe someone else might be able to validate this. Okay, this is not a wedding band. Wow. It's a very... Okay. All right, whoever has owned this, the first thing that pops into my mind is party. Party. Okay? Like there's been a celebration of some kind associated with this ring, with this bracelet.
We're getting short on time. Go ahead and finish this up real quick.
Okay. All right. All right. Someone is always prepared. Mm. This actually feels like whoever owned this is, they're not the first person to own this. This feels like it was something that was owned by two people, like it was passed along.
Given who's someone that? Else. Is someone
in the audience?
Oh, there we go.
Was this yours originally, or was this something that was passed to you?
That's original, yes.
It was, okay. Well.
It's probably his kids.
All right. All right, I'm going to say you're going to get over her. Is that relevant for you?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
Wow.
All right.
Well, so sometimes it hits, sometimes it
doesn't. He's beginning to cry, so for some reason.
That's not good.
Okay, I'm sorry if it isn't working.
That's all right. I know we need to go to commercial break, so again, they're going to stick around, so we can hear from Mark, Georgi, and John. Yeah. We're going to have a commercial break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. That was interesting. I think it was like this rant.
Golden brown, texture like sun, blaze me down.
Show. As I mentioned before, we have a group of musicians here that have been nice to come down on Saturday night. They'll be doing two songs for your pleasure. Can you please give a warm welcome to Dubbate? Dubbate!
Every minute now.
every minute now, live anywhere that you please, but make it count. Every minute now, live every day, just like in every minute now, every minute now, every minute now, live before your comes up and you have been found. Yeah, every minute now.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Jump, 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 jump,
You got to live, you got to breathe, you gotta dance, you got to feel, burn, you got to pray, you got to live every day, every second, yeah, every minute now.
Saturday night, Ryan, we only have a few more minutes. We want to make sure you get your second song. And what do you guys got coming up? What are your next gigs?
We play at the Firehouse Grill every month in Uptown Whittier. We're Dub 8. We're from Pico Rivera. Check out our website, dub8.com. We got a bunch of shows in Southern California. Thank you.
Yeah. You're going to be doing one more song. What song is that going to be?
This is a brand new one. It's called Dress in Yellow.
Ladies and gentlemen, time, Dub 8! Dub 8!
Step into your world. Show me everything, show me everything inside. Cause I'm knocking on your door. I'm just a man who needs some attention. Step into your world. Show me what you like, show me what you don't. Cause I'm knocking on your door. I'm just a man who needs some attention. Hey, you dressed in yellow. You got me buzzing again. Oh, the sweet smell of the sun. Can you capture this sensation? Stop the beat, so I could go to your distance. And we get to come to love decision. Now listen, whoa, the sweet taste of the one. Every time is a celebration. Whoa, the sweet taste of the one. Every time is a celebration. Shut up, vision. Now listen. Oh, the sweet taste of the world. Every time there's a celebration. Oh, the sweet taste of the world. Every time there's a celebration.
A couple more minutes before we're out of here. Is that right? Just a couple more minutes?
We're over.
We're over already. Again, we want to thank everybody. Just real quick for Mark. Actually, the ring that he was looking at actually did actually pan out, and the person actually did have some diabetes. So again, we want to make sure Mark gets that in. Okay, you can look at Mark's website. You log on to Marty'sCorner.com. We have the website link to all these folks. Of course, Georgi, John Kerwin. We want to thank you all. Take care. Dub 8 plus one more song. We're out of here. See you next month at Marty's Corner. Take care. Goodbye.
Thank you once again, we're Dub 8 from Pico Rivera, California. Check us out on MySpace at Dub8.com.
Of society, I'll keep walking through these alleys and I'll show no fear. I show no fear with this life's interrogation. I show no fear when what's wrong is an opinion. I show no fear in just a situation. I show no fear when it's time for some blood rush. So you pick it up. To free my mind, would it be too much to ask to know what is right? But I don't see myself going with.